Hey everybody, this is Josh Alexander from The Brokeredge and your host of Discover Yorba Linda. On today's episode, I'm going to be going over the pros and the cons of living in Yorba Linda. So if this is the first time you're checking out this channel is all things Yorba Linda. So I talk about the different businesses, restaurants, events, outdoor activities, and pretty much everything you'll need to know about living in Yorba Linda. So if you're living here currently or thinking about moving to this great city, make sure you hit that subscribe, like, as well as the bell button below if you're watching this on YouTube, and that way you're notified every week when I release a new episode. So let's go ahead and go over the pros and cons of living in Yorba Linda. Okay, so as you may or may not know, I was born and raised in Yorba Linda, so I'm going to try to keep this as unbiased as possible, and so I'm going to go over four of the pros and four of the cons to try to keep it evenly weighted. So let's go ahead and discuss the pros first. So the first pro is that Yorba Linda is quiet. So compared to a lot of Orange County, Yorba Linda is mainly made up of single family homes. So you're not stacked on top of each other. There's not a lot of condo complexes or apartment buildings within Yorba Linda. So you don't have as much traffic in Yorba Linda that you do in a lot of other Orange County cities. So you can leave your windows open. You're not hearing traffic all day. You're not hearing sirens, honking, people screaming. In general, Yorba Linda is a very quiet place, especially compared to the rest of Orange County. Okay, so the second pro of living in Yorba Linda, and this one is near and dear to my heart as a parent, is the great school systems here. So growing up in Yorba Linda, I remember enjoying school. I'm happy that I got a great education. I knew the school systems were good when I was going through them, and they've continued to be that way over the years. So when I did graduate college, we did leave Yorba Linda for a while. We went to more the center of Orange County because it was closer to my job, my wife's job, and it was closer to the middle of Orange County where everything was happening. However, when we found out that we were having a kid, one of the main reasons, besides the free babysitting from grandma and grandpa, that we moved back to Yorba Linda was that we wanted our kids to grow up and go into the school systems here because we knew how highly rated they were. However, don't just take my word for it. If you go on and look at some of the top sites for rating schools, like greatschool.org, you'll see that across the board, almost anywhere in Yorba Linda you go, those schools are gonna be rated either an 8, 9, or 10 out of 10. So you know with confidence that you've moved to Yorba Linda, your kid is going to get a great education inside the Placentia Yorba Linda School District. So pro number three, if you like outdoor activities, Yorba Linda is a great place to be. So let's go over a few of them. So first, let's start with biking. If you like biking, Yorba Linda is the hilliest, I'm not sure if that's a word, but hilliest, has the most hills out of almost anywhere in Orange County. So if you like to bike, it's a great place to be to challenge yourself. If you wake up in the morning in Yorba Linda, walk outside, take a drive, most likely you'll see bikers everywhere. So bikers come from all over the place to be able to use the roads here because there are a lot of bike lanes and they're expanding them constantly. They use the bike lanes, go around Yorba Linda. You can even take the bike lane from Yorba Linda down to the Santa Ana River Trail, all the way to the beach and back. So there's a lot of options if you're a biker for things to do in Yorba Linda. On top of biking, we also have over 100 miles of multi-use trails throughout the city. So you can hike on those, you can mountain bike on those, you can even horseback ride. So yes, Yorba Linda is also known to be a very horse-friendly city. There's a lot of horse properties, a lot of horse trails. So if you have a horse or are thinking of getting a horse, Yorba Linda is a great place to be for that as well. So on top of those trails that are in the city, Yorba Linda is also home to 29 different parks for humans and one dog park, so 30 parks altogether. And then on top of those 30 parks, we also have access right next to our city to some of the biggest parks around the area, which is Yorba Regional Park, where you can go paddle boating, you can take bike rides, you can go fishing. We also have access to Carbon Canyon Park, which to my knowledge has the only existing redwood forest within Orange County. So that's a cool place to check out. I'm sure I'll do an episode on that in the future, but that's a great place to go as well. And if those don't tickle your fancy, we are also backed right up to Chino Hills State Park. So if you're looking for for something more remote, that's a great place to go as well. There's plenty of hiking and biking back there that you can do and really explore the area without the big hustle and bustle of the city and get back to nature. So you have biking, you have hiking, you have horseback riding, you have a bunch of parks all over the city, you have some nature areas to go to if you want to. So hopefully you're able to find something that you enjoy outdoors in Yorba Linda. And that's one of the reasons that I love this place as well. I love getting outdoors, I love getting back to nature. So Yorba Linda is a great place to do that. So the fourth and the final pro that I wanna talk about in regards to Yorba Linda is just the friendly neighborhood environment. So I've lived in 5 different places within Yorba Linda, and I have nothing bad to say about all 5 of those locations. So growing up as a kid in Yorba Linda, I remember going outside every night, playing with friends, playing sports, hanging out. The parents hung out, everybody got along. When I moved back to Yorba Linda, once we had a kid, I lived on a small cul-de-sac. Everybody had each other's numbers. We all talked, we all communicated, and all had a great time. And then where I'm currently living right now, different neighbors in the neighborhood throw different parties, whether it's a movie night for the neighborhood, a giant slip and slide during the hotter months of the year, or a 4th of July bike parade for all the kids to go around the street to show off their decorations. It's a great neighborhood environment. It's something that's not apparent as you're just kind of driving through the city. So it is something that I want to bring up that not a lot of people see unless you're actually already living here. So now that I've talked about some of the great things about Yorba Linda, let's go over some of the cons as well, just so you can get a full rounded picture of exactly what it's like to live in this great city. Okay, so con number one is, unfortunately, it is expensive to live in Yorba Linda, more expensive than a lot of Orange County. So the average home price right now, the end of 2021, is right at $1.275 million. So it's not a cheap place to live. Now, if you're looking at more entry-level homes, you can find condos in the high fours, as well as single-family homes starting around the $800,000 mark. However, compared to most of Orange County, it's still a pretty expensive place to live, so that might keep some people out of this city. So con number two for living in Yorba Linda is that we do have a little bit more limited access to entertainment options, restaurants, and businesses compared to other places in Orange County that might be more in the central part of Orange County. So although we're a little bit farther away from the center of Orange County, we are starting to finally see more businesses open up. We are starting to see those options expand more, especially over the last couple years. We finally got a new town center, which has a movie theater in it, a bunch of shops, and we are seeing more and more restaurants and businesses opening up all the time. So over the last 2 months, we had a new Dollar Tree that just put in, a new pet store that was just put in. We also have new exercise places that you can go to now. And on top of everything else, we finally have an In-N-Out in Yorba Linda. So people have been asking forever for that. It just opened up a few days ago, so go check that out. It's over by the town center area, but In-N-Out just opened, so everybody can rejoice. So the third con of living in Yorba Linda, and this kind of goes back to us being a little bit more remote and a little bit farther away from the center of Orange County, is that it does take a little bit longer to get from your house to a freeway and then from a freeway to somewhere else that you're trying to go. So if you're trying to get to the center of Orange County, you can expect it to take 15, 20 minutes minimum, trying to get to the beach, probably 30 minutes or more depending on traffic. So depending on what your job is and where your job's located, as well as what you like to do on the weekdays as well as the weekends, you want to take that into consideration because you will have a larger commute time in general living in Yorba Linda compared to living someplace in the center of Orange County if you like to go out places often. So the fourth and final con of living in Yorba Linda has to do with what we back up to. So like I stated previously, we back right up to the hills of Chino Hills State Park. So although a lot of people see that as a positive, there are some risks involved. For instance, if you have a small dog or have an outdoor cat, you have to be very careful about where you live in Yorba Linda. The closer you are to the hills, the higher the coyote population is going to be. And there are plenty of instances, unfortunately, where coyotes have hopped over backyard fences, grabbed the small animal and taken off with it. So it's something that you really need to pay attention to and something that you have to plan for, that if you have a small dog or cat, that if they go to the bathroom at night, you need to be out there with them, supervising them. If you have a cat, it's probably best if they're an indoor cat. Otherwise, you do run the risk of them roaming around at night and running into coyotes. And you just want to make sure that you're staying vigilant on walks as well. So although it's rare, I have heard of residents say that coyotes will walk right up to them as they're walking their dog and try to snatch the dog off the leash. So again, it is rare that something like that would happen, but it's something that you should know about if you do have a small pet, so that way you can be prepared and really just take the proper measures to make sure everyone in your family, including your pets, stays safe. Now, on top of that, the other thing you need to know about living next to a state park like that is the fire risk. So the closer, again, you are to the hills, the more of a fire risk there is. So although fires don't happen very often in those hills, when they do, they can be devastating. So one thing you need to do if you're trying to purchase a house in Yorba Linda and it's next to a hill, you want to make sure that you're getting a fire insurance quote from your insurance provider before you get into escrow on that property. That way you know how much it's going to be, because it can get costly when you get to those very high fire risk zones to get that fire insurance. And if you're using a loan to get the house, most lenders are going to require that. So you want to make sure you know your financial obligations before you get into escrow on a home, and know that if you need fire insurance, how much it will be. So again, although having that state park backed up to Yorba Linda is nice, there are some things and precautions you have to know about living next to wildlife like that, as well as the fire risk that we face in California almost all year round at this point. And you need to make sure that you're aware of that and can really mitigate those risks as much as possible. So those are the pros and cons of living in Yorba Linda. Hopefully that gave you a clearer picture of what it's like to live in Yorba Linda. Now, before I let you go, if you are watching this and you are a resident of Yorba Linda, I would love to hear from you in the comments below what you think your pros and cons are of living in the city are, just so we can have other people's perspective as well. Because the more perspective we get, the more helpful it is for other people that might be thinking of calling this home in the near future. So please leave those comments below. I'd love to see that discussion to see how other people feel about living in Yorba Linda. So until next time, stay healthy, stay happy, and I'll see you on the next show. Bye.